apply the initial value problem of this function, of this equation here, and you're also given the condition. Oh, we're missing the condition, so let me write down the condition here. Okay, the condition is y of 0 equals 1 and y prime of 0 equals 0. Alright. First of all, what we are going to do is to rewrite this in one line by using the unit step function. Doing that, I will have. So we're going to start off with 1, okay? And then at pi over 2, we need to have psi. That means that I'm going to add negative 1 plus psi t. And of course, this multiplied by u of t minus pi over 2, okay? Okay, now let me multiply this, this out. So I have 1 minus 1 times u of t minus pi over 2 plus psi t u t minus pi over 2. Alright, so you're okay with this one. For this one, we need to get that t match up in order to find the Laplace transform. And in order to do that, well, let's just make it. Okay? And then I need to fix it. So we initially started off with psi. And we move to the right pi over 2 unit, which is here, right? And in order to keep this curve, it's not psi t minus pi over 2 anymore. At this point, you see we have a U-shaped curve. So this is the function of cosine, which is actually cosine of t minus pi over 2, okay? Now, it's time to apply the Laplace transform on both sides. On the left side, I have s squared capital Y of s minus s y of 0 minus y prime of 0 plus capital Y of s equals, on the right side, L of this is 1 over s, L of this is 1 over s, e to the negative pi over 2 s, plus L of this is s over s squared plus 1 e to the negative pi over 2 s. Okay. Now let's take a look at capital Y of s and factor it out. So I have s squared plus 1 equals, rewrite this. So for this one, y 0 equals 1, so we have negative s, multiply on the side, positive s, y prime of 0 equals 0, so just cancel, ignore it. Now let me divide both sides by s squared plus 1 to get capital Y of s alone. So I have 1 over s times s squared plus 1 minus 1 over s times s squared plus 1 e to the negative pi s over 2 plus s over s squared plus 1 squared e to the negative pi s over 2 plus s over s squared plus 1. Alright. Now for this one, we can find the Laplace transform of this. And what about 3 of these? Well, for this one, we can use the partial fraction. Oh yeah, these two, we can find, use partial fraction. But it's going to be lengthy. And I wouldn't do that because I'm a lazy person, okay? What I would do is to use a shortcut to find the composition. If you haven't had a chance to watch the video that I made about finding the composition in less than 30 seconds, I'll put the link in the upper right corner here so you can go ahead and watch that video. And it helps you a lot, like this case, it's already long, and if you just use a traditional method, it's gonna be longer than what we need to expect. Okay, like this last one, I need to multiply by top bottom by s to get s squared. And same for this one. And for this one, I need to have something over s squared plus something over s squared plus 1. Same for this one. Okay, let's do this first. Because these are the same. Okay, first of all, you need to have something over s squared plus something over s squared plus 1, which I already have here. Next step is to determine, the next step is to see. So these are off by 1, right? So this is s squared plus 0, s squared plus 1. They're off by 1, so I'm going to have 1 on the numerator. And the next step is to determine which one has a negative side. As I experienced, the bigger one will carry the negative side. It's just the double check. 1 times s squared minus s squared 0. 1 times 1, which is 1, which is what we have here. Right now, since this is the same as this, so just bring this over. Right? We do once, but we can use for 2. Alright. Let me use this from color here. Now for this one, oops. Okay, you can... Yes, you see it for this one. let me rewrite it using the derivative theorem, okay? And using that theorem, I would have negative derivative, the first derivative of 1 over square plus 1. Well, you don't have to get it exactly the correct form, just get it roughly first. So since I have s squared plus 1 square, I know that's gonna be something over s squared plus 1, and just pick 1 for simple math. Okay? And then how to fix it? Well, take the derivative of this one. So derivative of this one gives me 2s, and on the numerator I just have 1s, so I'm going to multiply by 1 half to compensate the 2 on top. Okay? And then on the bottom, just square. Alright, so the problem is fixed. And don't forget the e, this thing here. So it's just a constant. Right, now for this one, just rewrite it. We're almost done. Hang in there. Alright. This one, one more step. Distribute this, I have 1 over s squared minus s over s squared plus 1 minus 1 over s minus s over s squared plus 1 e to the negative pi s over 2, and rewrite this. Now take the to apply the inverse on both sides. On the left side I have y of t. On the right side I have 1, oh, this is just 1 over s, right? Because s over s, which is 1 over s, I get 1 minus, so this is cosine t minus 1 minus cosine of t minus pi over 2 times u of t minus pi over 2. Okay? Now for this one, let me do it down here because I am running out of space here. For that one, I have 1 half. This gives me t minus pi over 2 because I have the derivative, that means I have t. This one is a sine curve, so sine of t minus pi over 2. And don't forget, we have here the step function u of t minus pi over 2, okay? And last one, we have positive of cosine of t. Alright, simplify a little bit. Negative cosine, positive cosine, alright? So this should be your final solution eventually. And if you wonder why I have this massive thing here, but actually it's just t, psi t, and because we have u of t minus pi, so all of the t have to subtract pi over 2, and that's why I have all these t minus pi over 2, okay? So that's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.